And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Verstappen, Norris, and George Russell. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That's how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. The prestigious Circuit de Monaco, then, is not all that dissimilar today to the layout that made its debut almost a century ago. It's 2 miles and 19 corners through the streets of Monte Carlo. And although the average lap speed of around 93 miles per hour is the lowest of the season, the tiny margins for error make it the natural habitat of the safety car. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And Lando Norris lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Russell, Hamilton, Charles Leclerc, and Perez. Fernando Alonso, Sainz, Ricciardo, and Pierre Gasly. Albon, Ocon, Kevin Magnussen, and Mick Schumacher. Bottas, Tsunoda, Guan Yu Zhou, and Lance Stroll. Vettel, Latifi, Richard Vershaw, and Kyle. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat is Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching out for as they head into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. lap. We can use DRS when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, we've been given a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race. Get your head down and let's get it done. Okay, gap ahead is 2.0 seconds. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
that's it then for another nail-biting Monaco Grand Prix. We were on the edge of our seats the whole time, but they've come through to take a stunning victory. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today? Our winning drivers are on their way to the podium right now. It's been a fantastic race for McLaren, that's for sure. And no doubt, they'll be celebrating tonight. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. The gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
I have to give it to Kyle. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
Let's move on to the constructors. Ferrari continue to extend the gap at the top of the table. There was also a strong showing from the Mercedes team today as they make their way up the standings. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.